My friend in Germany has designed another clock. This one is called the Lazy Word Clock. The LEDs start here, come across, bend, loop around, go back and forth. One LED illuminates one of these little boxes. And it goes all the way back and forth until you get to here, then the LEDs stop here. And that corresponds to these letters. AM and PM are not illuminated in this sketch. These small LEDs are on one continuous strip, and there are 60 per meter. These are made up of 500 millimeter lengths, so there's a solder joint every half meter. There are two sides to these LEDs. You get the 5 volt and the ground, but this side is signal in and this side is signal out. We're actually going to induce power on this end of the strip. We're going to connect plus and minus here, and it will feed power the full length of this strip. And then a plus and a minus will come from here. It will go to the Arduino Nano and the real-time clock. And then the signal wire from the Nano comes back to this side, and it goes to DI, or signal, or digital in, and feeds the signal down the line of LEDs. Each one of these LEDs has its own microprocessor built in here. And so the signal is designed such that that microprocessor can determine whether it's supposed to turn on or off or change color or whatever. When you run across one of these projects on the internet, you never know if it's going to actually work or if it's just going to be a mess. When you look at one of Daniel's clock designs, you can be absolutely assured that this thing is going to work as presented. His parts fit perfectly. He puts a lot of time and effort into his designs. This one uses Arduino Nano and a clock module. One of the advantages of one of these clocks is a battery in this clock module. So if you have a power failure, when the power comes back on, the time is right back there again. This uses one of these little tiny push-button switches, and there is a right and a wrong way to wire one of these, so you do need to pay attention. Daniel's articles are very descriptive. He gives all the information that you will need. And these little plastic pieces push in here and retain those push buttons. Those are used for setting the time. And then there's a cover plate for that electric box. This is designed so this clock module will pass through a hole in the board and just lay on here, and it will not protrude far enough to interfere with the clock. I decided to do it a little differently. I made one of these bases, and it lines up with the three holes in this board. The pins will stick up through the holes in the board. And I made those pins a little bit longer. And so you position that on this, and when you get it where you want it, then I just wick a little glue under there, which will glue this part to that. I just take a hot soldering iron and melt those pins over, and it won't come off of there. I've redrawn this to where this bottom part now is about 2 millimeters shorter, because I did have this sticking up a little bit too high. Another solution for this being too high is to just cut these pins off and take this black plastic out of here and solder directly to the pin sticking out of the board, just like what I've done here with the Nano. Then when you put this board on here, you won't have an interference. In my case, this was sticking up a little bit. I had to route away a little bit of this material. So you can see it just barely hits. So shortening this up should take care of that problem, and or cutting these off and making the connections lower to the board. My Nano was already mounted on pin headers. I chose to make my connections on top of the board and then I bent over a few of the header pins to secure the nano in place. And you can see how much my clock module protrudes with my base. You're provided a pattern for a diffuser. This is just a piece of printer or typing paper. This goes on top of there like so. This was designed to use a frame that is readily available in Europe. I could not find that frame here, so I will be making my own frame. I haven't done that yet. And in the original frame, the backing of the frame was used to cover this. So I'm using a piece of masonite, and then this piece goes on here. I'm temporarily using these wires to test the clock. When the power cord is installed, and this is operated from a 5-volt USB power supply, just like you would use to charge your cell phone, that power cord will come down through here, and then there's a slot in here. You can use a small zip tie to hold that power cord so it stays centered on the clock. One problem I've encountered with these strips, not on this clock, but on some others, that little circuit board that's right here next to the LED, if you are not paying attention, you can knock one of those off when you're pushing it down between some of these plastic channels. That little chip will look like a speck of dust on your workbench and you won't notice it. And when you plug in the clock to test it, the nano will go up in smoke. Once you see or smell smoke off of one of these, it is too late to unplug it. This is a very finely detailed print, and the detail really is in the center of some of these letters and that very small support bar that holds them in position. Now, I recently upgraded my Ender 3 Pro, and it did a real good job on this. There's one more piece to this, which is the mask. Now, this is printed on a piece of paper. The actual mask will be printed on an overhead projector transparency, and what is white here will be transparent on the actual mask. It can be scratched up easily, so I haven't printed it yet, but that'll be on there. There's going to be a real thin piece of glass on the front of that. These positions are all threaded for an M3 thread. You need to remember this is laminated PLA. And just take one of these fasteners and run it in and out gently several times to form the thread. And then when you assemble it, this does not have to be tight, just snug. If you over-tighten it, you're going to break something.